Hello YouTube friends. Recently someone asked me about my process step by step for preparing enrichment for brine shrimp, which I feed to my dwarf seahorses, so I thought I would do a short video on it. Here's a bottle, about a liter, that used to have vinegar in it and was rinsed very well, and this has worked the best for me as far as storing enrichment in my refrigerator after I have prepared it. One of the ingredients I use to make my brine shrimp enrichment is Marine Plus Enhanced Marine Flakes, which has a probiotics formula in it. I also add Cool Mix or Cool Flakes from Brine Shrimp Direct, and it's a combination of four different flakes. It includes garlic, spirulina, mysis, krill, and I like it because it has immune boost and color enhancing properties. I also add additional spirulina powder, which I also get from Brine Shrimp Direct. I also add highly unsaturated fatty acid powder, or HUFAs, which I also get from Brine Shrimp Direct. I don't use any kind of precise measurement, but essentially use approximately 1 teaspoon of each of the ingredients and put them in a coffee grinder. Once everything is in the grinder, I put the lid on and I start the grinding process. And after a few minutes, you can see it's pretty well ground. I then use a little brush that came with the coffee grinder, and I get all of the powder that's sticking on the lid and I put that in a glass jar. I add the contents from the grinder, and once again I take the brush and I get out any residue that's left and put it in the glass jar. So by the time I'm done, almost the entire bottom of the glass jar is full of the ground powder. And this is just a close-up of the brush that I used for the cleaning. I suppose a regular toothbrush would work as well, but I just use this one because it came with. Then next, I add some prepared seed water, and I don't fill the jar all the way up. I just fill it just a little bit, maybe an inch, inch and a half, and then I stir up the water and the powder. And then I let it sit for about an hour or two before I stir it up again. Then I use some sieves to filter out the larger particle sizes of the powder. There's a stack of three. The top layer, I believe the microns is the unit used to measure. It's 120, the center one is 250, and then the one in the bottom is 520. So the most coarse of the powder gets filtered out on top, and I have to use a stirring motion, a vigorous stirring motion, to get that water to go down, which is one reason why I don't fill that glass jar with water, because it does take some effort to get the little bit of water down into the sieve. When just about all of the liquid is gone, you'll notice the next layer there's still a lot of liquid, and I just do the same process. I stir vigorously until the water is mostly gone from that layer of the sieve. And when the liquid in the second layer is just about gone, then I complete the process with the third sieve, which is the finest one. And the most challenging to get the liquid out, but just continue the same process of vigorously stirring until the liquid seeps down through the sieve and leaves behind the larger particles of the powder. When I'm finished, I end up with a very dark green rich liquid, which I am ready to start pouring into the bottle. Notice there's only just a little bit of liquid in the bottle, but it's very dark green. So this is still enough where I'm able to add some water to it, some more fresh seawater to dilute it, And by the time that I'm finished, I'm still going to have a very rich green brine shrimp enrichment. And there we have it, another full bottle of enrichment, and that will probably last me about a week and a half to 2 weeks, and then I'll repeat as needed. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this helpful. Please feel free to reach out with any questions. I'd love to make a video about them. Thank you, and take care.